A second inquiry into Kathleen Folbigg's 2003 conviction for killing her four children has begun in Sydney. Her fate could now rest on a genetic mutation. We go now to Jane Hansen, Sunday Telegraph's investigative reporter and host of News Corp's podcast Mother's Guilt. She joins us now. Jane, how significant is this new evidence of this exceptionally rare genetic mutation?
Well, the science is pretty solid, which is why 151 eminent scientists from around the world have signed this petition to pardon Kathleen Folbigg. I don't think it's unprecedented in Australia, that's for sure. And it's a little bit complex, but they have managed to prove that the mutations found in Laura and Sarah, the two girls, is linked to cardiac arrhythmias. And they believe that they've proven that by reproducing this mutation in a lab and then testing it again and again and finding that it is pathogenic, meaning it is disease-causing.
What I don't understand about this, though, Jane, maybe you can help me out, is the cardiologist found the condition may only exist in two of the kids who were allegedly murdered, or I suppose found to have been murdered. What about the other two kids who died, though? What's the story meant to be there?
Well, Caleb and Patrick died of different things. They found that Caleb died of SIDS, but he also had a floppy larynx, which is, in the literature, can be linked to sudden infant death. And Patrick had seizures or epilepsy. Now, these two children are not carrying that mutation. The significance, I guess, of the two girls carrying the mutation is because all four were tried together as one case. If two fall over, the whole case falls over and has to go back to the Court of Criminal Appeal. And that, of course, creates reasonable doubt. You know, there's been holes in the smothering case from day one, because there was never any forensic evidence that she smothered the children, none whatsoever. So it was a circumstantial case. And very much part of it was that many of the experts hadn't seen four sudden infant deaths in one family. Back then in 2003, there was a little bit of a legal fad that, you know, one sudden infant death was a tragedy, two suspicious, three possibly murder. That definitely came in the back door. And that was just proven to be wrong.
You've done the deep dive on this for your podcast, Jane. Simple question. What's the possibility that Kathleen, after 20 years, could walk out of jail a free woman?
Some of the legal experts I've spoken to say if this is proven and the inquiry finds, yes, these two children likely died of this mutation, she will, of course, get out. It might go back to the Court of Criminal Appeal. You know, that's up to Justice Bathurst when he writes his report. And he said today in the inquiry that he was going to take into account all the evidence, not just the science. He was going to take into account the diaries, which were also part of the circumstantial evidence that convicted her. And we will hear more about that in February. And in fact, today we also learnt that this inquiry, 2 weeks was supposed to be put down for the science, it's going to be adjourned until next February after tomorrow's evidence, because there's some new science that's only just come in the last 48 hours that strengthens the original findings from the Danish professors who found this mutation was pathogenic. They have now given a further submission, and the inquiry is now going to be postponed for a couple of months so that the other experts can digest this new evidence. We'll hear about that tomorrow, what the new evidence is, but it's set to be quite explosive.
Well, we'll watch and wait, Jane. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
And details for Jane's podcast are on our website as well.